I want the hole half an inch in plus half the width of my cutter. That's 906 thousandths. So here we go. Which would be, let's see, that's 8, that's 5, 6, 7 turns. Now we'll just go the half inch in first. That'll be 4/8. 1, 2, 3. There's 4/8, those are half inch. Now we want 406 thousandths on top of that. So that'd be 3 more turns. That's 375, 380, 90, 400, 406. Remember your backlash all the time. Don't ever turn this back this way. Always turn it so it's going in the direction you actually want it to move, because you've got quite a few thousandths in backlash on any of these. That's just the way it is. Okay, now we're ready to cut our piece. It's an annular cutter. It's in an R8 mounting. They're pretty common. You can pick them up just about anywhere, I think. I've had mine for quite a few years. It's handy. I have a low power milling machine, and it turns it into a pretty nice whole hog. I always use lubricant, keeps your cutters lasting longer. It's plain old flood lubricant. You really don't want your hands near that, because you're going to have a lot of chips coming off this thing and it'll grab your hand. This is a hole for a 3/4 inch pin, so it's, I'm setting it up at 13/16. I like to stop it and get these off every once in a while. Otherwise, they get out of hand. Yeah, you don't want your fingers anywhere near that while it's turning. You don't want them getting too long, because it can reach out and snag you. I run at pretty low RPM, keeps the heat down, and a fairly heavy chip load. Get that puppy out of there. We'll get her. There we go. Kind of shove it off the side so it, the new chips can't snag the old ones. Then you have just a great big huge ball. It's half inch plate. Yeah, I probably could run that a little higher off the, I think we'll do that, make it a little easier. There. We need a little more clearance. There we go. This will probably put us through this batch anyhow. I had my drill stop set there. Mm-hmm. Sometimes those slugs pop out, sometimes they don't. A lot of times you can just tap them. I generally use a little screwdriver. Anyhow, they were done. There it went. Took a little while. The beauty to these annular cutters, let's see if I can find the slug, I don't know where it went, because they don't have to cut as much material. Oh, there we go. They don't have to cut as much material, so it take use a lot less power. See, that's your core right there, and you're just cutting around that instead of like a drill. You'd have to cut that whole mess out there. You'd have a pile of chips and need a lot of power. Anyhow, that's how to set one up. It's pretty simple. You don't need all that fancy stuff. And you're in business. All right, y'all take care. Mark there to show you that you're not crashing that cutter into the side of that metal. I mean, that's just a tiny little, you can't even hardly feel it with your fingernail. And the same on this side. See, it's just got a little right there. It's the easy way to do it. You don't need all that fancy stuff. All right.